Hello children, I am your teacher Gundeep. Hope you all are staying safe at home. Children, we have started the chapter, The Shoemaker. Let us recapitulate what we did yesterday. Dr. Manette is freed from 18 years of imprisonment. He has lost almost all his memory. Monsieur Defarge, Mr. Lorry and his daughter comes to visit him. The shoemaker is busy at his task of shoemaking, but he pays little attention to them. Then children, what happens? Mr. Lorry tries his best to recall real Dr. Manette from almost a faint person who was almost lost in his thoughts. When the visitors inquire him of his name, the shoemaker responds, 105 North Tower. Children, unfortunately, he can only link himself with the number of his prison cell. He can't remember his name. He can't remember anything. But he says that I'm not a shoemaker by trade, by profession. He calls himself a shoemaker because that is what he was taught to do in the prison. And so the chapter's title is also The Shoemaker. He is lost. Yet he seems to be aware of only one task. What was his task? Yes, the shoemaking. He was consistently busy with his own work. After a while, Mr. Lorry approaches him and asks, "Do you remember me? Can you recognize me?" He was startled. The shoemaker drops the shoe in his hand. He recognized the face of his old employer, Monsieur Defarge. But again he resumed back to his work. The shoemaker looks turn by turn at Mr. Lorry and Monsieur Defarge. Lucy is still standing at the doorside looking at her father. She advances forward slowly but trembling with eagerness to hold his face. She could see the clouds of darkness on her father's face. He was least bothered about the visitors who came to meet him, just as if the shoes are only remnants of his lost word. He could only recognize his shoes and his own job, nothing else. Then the shoemaker stares at Lucy with a fearful look. He holds a knife, but after a while his lips begin to form some words, though no sound proceeded from them. The daughter, Lucy, she is very anxious to meet her father. She cries on meeting her father. She had no fear of his striking at her with the knife, although Defarge and Lorry looked very scared. The shoemaker asks Lucy, "Are you the jailer's daughter?" She says no. She sits beside him, but the shoemaker immediately moves back. He had a strange thrilling experience. But he again started his task of shoemaking. Children, a very emotional scene is described in the last paragraphs of the chapter when the shoemaker drops the knife and picks up the shoe with the other hand and again gets back to his work. At this stage of his life, the shoemaking, the task of shoemaking was the only thing that gave him happiness. So this was the chapter about the shoemaker. I hope you have understood the explanation. You have to solve the questions on the basis of comprehensive approach and do the word meanings. Thank you, children. Stay home, stay safe, and be happy.